Now. Welcome everybody, welcome to the second hottest show on phones. This is an exciting show for many reasons. First of all, it is the second appearance of Eli Leonard. We asked him back. He got another shot. It's like when you do your first shot on a big show, you wait and you wonder, will they ask me back? Will they ask me back on the show? We've invited back Eli for more Eli-ing. We'll check in with him shortly. Also, I'm excited because my good friend and the amazing Jessica Kirson is in her house. Yes. The great and talented Jessica Kirson. You know, this show, I feel like I'm blurry up here.
It's the sun.
Is it the sun?
Yeah. You're good, then.
This show is so exciting. I'm so proud of the work that I do on this show. Just yesterday, and it is a show. It's a big show, and the work that I do. Yesterday, we had the great Josh Molina on. And Josh and I were talking about how Jewy Josh is, and I talked about how I put on phylacteries. Posted it last night, already has thousands of views. People are sharing it on WhatsApp, and I'm getting tons of DMs. I want to show you a DM I got last night from a fan. Zoom in on that so they could see it. What it says, it's below that. Yeah, let's keep going down. Yeah, there it is. Remember where it was in rehearsal? It was on the bottom of the screen. Remember where it was half hour ago when we went over this? So he said, this clip of you and Josh Molina, it made my day and God's, I'm sure. I made God's day yesterday. I don't know how many people out there can say that about themselves. Like, did you make God's day yesterday? How many people made God's day? I make God's day with this show. So for those of you that think this is just an ordinary Instagram live or you're not watching anything special, this is God's show. This is the show that makes God's day. This is God's show. This is the show that I should be struck by lightning right now during this riff. This is a show that makes God's day. It's the second hottest show on phones, and it's the show that makes God's day. Thank you. And this is my mood face today. It's angry. You know, this is the first time in history that I changed my mood face. My mood face just an hour ago was this. And I'll tell you why I was this. Because I was excited that for the first time ever, I have my very first studio audience member. That's Jessica, everybody. Jessica Wade, who happens to work with me on a lot of my social media stuff. She also animates the fantastic new Brief Briefing Trump cartoons we're putting out there that are going viral, that are TikToking at a TikTok near you. Jessica calls me. I'm on my way down, driving down from Portland. Can I stop by and watch the live taping? It's a live taping of the big show. And I said, you could be our first studio audience member. And I was so excited. I was like, I have an audience. And that's why this was my mood face. But it changed to this. Because my father, who I warned my parents, I said, I'm having company, don't go near them. They just touched gas stations and all sorts of rest stop areas. She's probably got it. If she doesn't have it, she's carrying it. She's a, what do they call it? A silent, she's an asymptomatic.
Or pre-symptomatic.
She's pre-symptomatic. She's something with matics and symptoms. Don't go near her. This is my dad 10 minutes ago. Let me see if I could play it on this, because I have it also.
Yeah, you
should do that. Yeah. Okay, so that's him, but you don't hear me yelling at him. Play it. Can you play it? Yeah, play it. I want you to play it. I'm screaming, move back from Jessica! No! It's like you watch that thing. You know in the movies in slow motion when they're about to be killed and the person who doesn't want their friend to be killed goes,
move back from Jessica, no!
Do that again.
No!
No! That slow motion. No! And then it's like, and it still happens. The explosion still happened. Despite my... No! No, it's not a Jerry Seinfeld scream. Someone commented, this is a Jerry Seinfeld scream. What are you doing? You gotta move away! It's Jessica! She's got the COVID! That wasn't Seinfeld. That was a... No! So that's my father, and I was upset. That's why my mood face is angry now. It's this. And it is Wine Wednesday, by the way, where we drink wine and we whine about stuff. Today, courtesy of Herzog. Herzog makes a fantastic special reserve 2016. What is this? Oh, Lake County Cabernet. It's a Lake County Cabernet we're enjoying.
Ooh.
We drink wine and we whine. And today I would like to continue whining about my parents because it is day 101. It is day 101 of them being here. I love my parents. They're welcome to stay here for another 1,000 days. Really. They can't. I stayed in their house for 20 years. You know what I mean? I stayed from birth to like college-y, and then I even came back and stayed a little bit. Why shouldn't I, you know, repay the favor? They could stay, but they just can't annoy me. Because instead of being like grateful, oh, he's so nice, he opens his home. Of course he does, he's our son. My mom runs it, she rushes the studio, bursts in unannounced, uninvited, to yell at me that I yelled at her. Now, I don't yell at my parents unless, as you just saw, they're in a life-threatening situation where Jessica will infect them with her diseases. I don't yell at my parents. I'm very nice to my parents. I told them to, 101 Dalmatians. What was the joke we were working on before this? Oh, that there should be a college, when you go to college, everything is, you know, 101. It should be family 101. Don't stay past 100 day 40 or 3. Just don't stay. Mom? Now everybody thinks that I'm an elder abuser, that I'm not nice to you. Am I nice to you, Mom?
No, it's just a role reversal.
Right.
He thinks he's the father,
right,
and I'm the child,
right,
who needs to be taken care of, and he barks, go outside in the sun. He's just being overprotective. He micromanages me, and I'm getting tired of it. But he's so good. Like this morning, I'm just about finishing my breakfast cereal.
Yeah.
He brings me sushi, which I love. He doesn't know what to do for me.
It was yesterday's sushi.
But he's too good.
I was going to throw it out.
He's,
I just gave it to her instead of throwing it out. Thank you, Mom. Get out! And book those flights! Anyway, that was Wine Wednesday. Let's go. Do we see the Wine Wednesday? Go get out of this.
Morning.
Oh, that was her yesterday.
Kitchen,
we saw that. It's too much. Too much of a bad thing. I saw Jessica Kirson is here. Thank you for watching, Jessica. We're getting to you in a few minutes. Thank you for the compliment. My hair does look good today, doesn't it? That was Wine Wednesday, Jessica. Now we're on to Wow, Evans, you're really asleep. You're asleep at the wheel today.
You're asleep.
No, but I changed my mind. I'm moving at the flying at the seat of my pants. It's that kind of show. We're up to Eli-ing. Eli, where's he? Go to Eli-ing. Eli Leonard is. We always try to check in. What is Eli-ing up to? Last time he was Eli-ing in the at a protest. I think he went to another protest today. I'm not sure. Eli, would you say hi? And he has lie in his name, but he always speaks truth.
There he is.
So here we go. We're going live with Eli Leonard. Eli, what are you Eli-ing about today? Wow. It's Wine Wednesday.
It's schwitzing over here, baby. I've got the wine in my hand. I'm doing the prayers just like you told me, buddy.
Be honest.
Just like you told me.
Be honest, Eli. Did you, when you saw that it was Wine Wednesday, did you run just now and grab this wine?
Richard, I can't catch my breath. I took my inhaler and everything. So I did. I sprinted.
Why are you blurry? Why is your Wi-Fi not good?
I didn't do anything wrong.
Hit your phone. Give it a zest.
Okay, here. Is it good?
Give your phone a zets.
Is this good? Is it good?
All right. Tell us, good? Are you, Eli, last time you were here, you reported on the, now we lost.
I think that's better. I think I know what's wrong. Oh, it's better. Okay. I think I know what's wrong. I'm not rich.
You think I'm rich?
Yeah, I do. I've been to your house.
No.
There's three floors. There's two floors and a back room.
There's two. Don't make up another floor. Don't imagine a floor. You're putting on imaginary floors onto my house. That's a modest, nice house.
Okay,
that
but
I'm
I do
sorry.
Comment,
I'm sorry.
I kind of. You first, then me.
I'm sorry that Pam Anderson hired me to be in a sitcom and I had a down payment. I'm sorry that I wrote enough good jokes over the last 10 years that I was able to pay my mortgage.
What are you apologizing for? I'm not saying anything's wrong with the way you live. I'm saying I'm broke as shit and my Wi-Fi's no good. You have a house with two stories, okay? And in the backyard, there's another little house that's fit for a king with two stories itself. This is poor.
What are you Eli-ing about? We have to bring on Jessica in 2 minutes. What are you Eli-ing about today?
Oh, nuts. Well, okay, I'm taking a big rest today from the protests. I was out so long. And
there's no rest from a cause like that. You don't get
no,
to go rest.
I know. There's no rest, but to be on the streets, you know, Shabbat's the day of rest. This is my protest Shabbos. I can't deal with it anymore.
Wednesday. It's the middle of the whole point of Shabbat is at the end of a weary, hardworking week. You take the day off to rest. It's Wednesday.
Yeah, but you know, Adonai. Okay, he didn't think that there would be people slain in the streets for no reason the week before, and people would be marching all day long for seven straight days. You think the Orthodox should be taking off Saturday if there's a big protest for Black Lives Matter? No chance. Okay, I'm taking my time. Wednesday, it's a light day for protest.
So you have chosen Wednesday as your Sabbath.
This week, it's a balance, it's a wave, it's a spectrum, just like life, dude, just like golf, just like the stock market.
Move back, please.
Just
move
like
back.
Cali.
There's only
baby.
So much Eli we could take. Eli, yeah. Eli, I think what I'm getting at also is that you're afraid, because you mentioned that it's dangerous out there, so that you don't want to get caught up in all, it's less of a rest day and more of a, I don't want to get killed today day.
Oh, you know, I really, you know, I don't really fear dying.
Why?
It's not in my blood. I mean, I'm scared of going to the hospital at the moment.
You would rather die than go to a hospital.
Well, at the moment, I think going to the hospital is the only place it's sure that you have a good chance of dying. You know, except for putting a gun to your head.
Or dying.
COVID.
Dying is also a good chance you'll have of dying.
There's what?
No, better than, you know what's a bigger chance of dying than going to the hospital? Dying.
What? Dying.
Yeah.
Oh, good. Dying's a better chance. Dying is dying. We're doing Seinfeld again. Ah! Oh, hang on. I just started to feel it. So, is it time for Jessica? I'm so sorry if I'm cutting
you. Yeah, we're bringing Jessica in, but what do you have? Something in your hair?
I found something in my hair. I found the Afikoman.
From Pesach?
Yeah, this is months old.
Some kid hid the Afikoman in your hair.
You owe me $2, and so does my grandpa, my grandma, my aunt, my uncle, my mother's aunt, who I never see and has only ever given me a $2 bill, and I don't know anything about her life. I
mean, Have you showered since April?
No. What would be the point? What would be the point of washing my body at a moment like this?
So there is matzah.
This has rats. There's Afikoman.
Children hid matzah in your hair a month and a half ago.
Since when do the children hide the Afikoman?
Who did it? Who hid it?
My grandpa.
Oh, he hid it.
The Baal HaBait, huh?
Oh, right. He hides it and then the kids find it. I'm sorry. You're right.
Yeah.
Your grandfather hid the Afikoman in your hair. Well, we can't top that. So I think we should end on that.
Okay. Yeah. Let me go.
What does it say on it? Afikoman?
It says Yid Gadol.
Yeah, why?
It says Yid Gadol because that's the end of the show, baby. I'm out of here.
Love you. Thank you. Eli Leonard, everybody. Another stellar appearance. He earned his third appearance. He's like the young comedian showing up. People are saying they love you. Everyone go, Eli, Eli. Who wants Eli back next week? Because I do. That was when you're a young comedian and you're on an old comedian show, you want to impress them. You want to make them laugh so you get, an ass back. And he was ass back for sure. Let me hear Eli. Eli. There you go.
Eli. Fantastic.
That was fantastic. Fantastic. Yep, everybody wants Eli. Everybody loves Eli. And Audrey, my daughter's just saying hi.
Just someone else.
They're talking to each other. Jessica Kirson, is she in her house? Jessica Kirson is one of those comedians. Jessica, I'm sorry. I know I told you you'd be on 625. We're running late, but Eli was just fantastic. And then, oh my God, did I forget to mention again? We have a great musical guest. The brothers Koren are in their house. We have a comedian and we have a musical guest. So we're going to talk to Jessica for a few minutes and then we're going to hear a phenomenal song by the brothers Koren. Wow, I'm just so excited to be doing nothing. Jessica? Jessica,
hi.
How are you?
I'm in bed.
Are you? Why? It's only 9:30 in New York.
Because I'm miserable. That was so funny.
Isn't Eli?
First of all, he is, I don't even know who that is. He's brilliantly funny.
So he's Larry David's production assistant, and I met him on the set of
Her. He's hysterical.
He's also a comedian and a great comedy writer. I met him, fell in love, because how do you not fall in love with that?
Yeah, he's hysterically funny.
Well, he's no you, Jessica, and this is about you.
I don't say that a lot. But he
I know
really
you
is.
Don't.
And when he pulled that Afikoman out of his hair, I laughed out loud, which takes, I mean.
Let me tell you why you don't say that a lot. Because you are what we in the business call a comic's comic.
That's very sweet. Thank you so much.
You're a bit of a comedy snob, let's be honest.
No, I'm not. You mean like, in what way?
Jeff Garlin's watching, by the way. Don't we love Jeff Garlin? I love him.
I love him. Jeff Garlin.
So you're a comedy snob in the way that you like great comedians. Like when you're a Cellar regular. Anyone that's at the Cellar is a great comedian. SD doesn't just pass crap. But you're one of those comedians that's even one notch above a regular Cellar because other comedians like myself will watch you while you're on stage.
I watch you on stage too. I think you're brilliant.
Oh, that's so nice.
But, I'm not just saying that.
That is so nice. But again, it's not about me. It's definitely not about Eli, right?
I just wish you wouldn't take all the Jewish gigs because I have kids. I need gigs. And you're just always you and Modi hog every Jewish gig.
I know, but I have a 3-story home that I have.
But I gotta throw some to me. I'm a woman.
I promise I will, and I do, and I have. Yeah. But wait, here's the point about you. You're one of those comedians love to watch. You, and your motto is, what is it? Always be silly?
Yep. Oh, it has been for 20 years.
But you're smart, silly. You're clever, silly. Mm-hmm. Just this one thing that, I don't know, and I wanted to ask you, when did you think of it and how long you've been doing it? This one, I'll call it a device, that you turn around, turn your back to the audience, something that's so brave and crazy and courageous,
in the middle of your set several times, you will turn around. I wish we had a clip. I should have gotten a clip of it.
I know. I can't do it from home. Like, if I do a Zoom show, I look mentally ill, like, very mental. It's not, I am mentally ill, but I look like I need to be brought to a hospital immediately if I turned around and talked to myself.
But tell the folks what you do and how you thought of it and when. What do you do exactly? Like, give a perfect example.
Okay,
like, you'll be
so
doing
I realized, right, and I realized over years that the only time it works really, really well is when a joke doesn't land the way I want it to, or if I'm in my head about something. Mm-hmm. So I'll turn around and bend over in a fetal, you know, like, with my back, my, whatever, who cares? I have a fatty cyst. Did you ever hear of, I've never even knew what a fatty cyst, I have a fatty cyst in my shoulder.
I'm trying to learn about your process, and you're talking about fatty cysts.
I'm going to tell you why, because every time before this pandemic happened and I turned around, I was self-conscious about people seeing my golf ball-sized fatty cyst in my shoulder. So I have fat on my fat. It's a major. So
can a cyst lose weight? Like, if you're at the gym, are you thinking about that also? Are you focusing on the cyst losing weight?
I think it's a separate, it's like I have a person on my person. Yeah, a lipoma. I think it's called a lipoma. See, I have doctors in the family, but not for that.
So tell us about this.
Don't rush me.
I'm
so
sorry.
And by the way,
let me just say this. You have a fantastic special out on Comedy Central called...
Yes, Talking to Myself.
Where you do this a lot.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
So go on. I'm going to have a drink of wine while you tell us what you do, how you do it, when you thought of it, and how you thought of it. Go ahead.
Okay. My stepbrother is Zach Braff. So I'll turn like
That's
when
the
a joke
only reason I had you on, because your stepbrother
is
Zach Braff.
And he's dating Florence.
I don't think you're funny.
It's...
I don't like you as a person. I had you on because your stepbrother is Zach Braff.
My father passed away.
I'm sorry. And I was just acting. I was auditioning. That was my...
Okay. Okay. I know, you're hysterical. So when things don't go well, when I'm on stage, I'll turn around and say, it's okay, Jessica, you're doing great. You need to love yourself. It's all going to be okay. And then I end with something crazy, like, you need to stop eating salads in public. You're not fooling anyone. Like, that kind of thing.
So you're just talking to yourself.
Yeah, because I'm always in my head and talking to myself. So that I decided I'm just going to let it out on stage. Or I'll talk about people who aren't laughing at me. I'll be like, the guy at table 23 in the blue shirt, it's not about you. He hates himself, you know.
I'm so jealous of that. The only comedian I ever paid to see was Gilbert Gottfried.
Oh my God.
Amazing. And he used to do thoughts that the audience is thinking. And Gaffigan does that also sort of.
Right. I would die.
Right. Gilbert would be doing a bit and then he'd be like, oh, this guy.
Yeah, I've seen it.
Yeah, this guy. And he starts talking about what the audience is thinking. So that is your own original take on it, but it's you talking to yourself. It's not the audience thoughts. I freaking love it so
Thank
much.
You.
So when did you develop it?
I did it for years and like it just wasn't working a lot. And there's some places I don't do it because they're so dumb. Like they're just not going to get it. I can't do it in the middle of Albany. Like I can't turn around. They're gonna be like, what this girl did? Like they're not gonna understand.
Why is she not facing us? And why do we sound like we're below the Mason-Dixon line when we're way above it?
Because they do sound like that.
They
there.
Do. It's
I know.
Weird.
It turns
Hicks or Hicks.
It turns into the South. Even
it
in upstate
the North
New York.
Becomes
yeah.
the South. They fought themselves in the Civil War. Jessica, I actually prepared questions for you, and then we have a great musical group on. So can I just ask you a couple of questions?
Who's on?
They're called the Brothers Koren. They're fantastic. Wait till you just stick around for that.
Is it Jewish music? I can't. Mm-hmm. I got to call someone. Is it Jewish music? I'm sorry. I really do have to make a call.
Okay, fine. It's the opposite of Jewish music.
Oh, so
these, when it, you see, yeah, no. But when you see these two guys... These two guys are when they wanted the Aryan race. This is them. You'll see what I mean in a moment. But wait, before we go, 1 second. By the way, Bill Burr, who I just saw last night in Judd's movie, Tour de Force performance, he recognized your brilliance and produced that special that's on Comedy Central. How much do we love Bill Burr?
Yeah, that was amazing. And you said something to me so sweet right after that. You really did. You came up to me at the cellar and you said, now everyone will see what we've always known. It was really a beautiful thing to say to me.
Yes.
I'm doing a Zoom shows out of my walk-in closet.
And what there's a part two to what I said to you.
Mm-hmm.
What I said to Sebastian Maniscalco, I will now say to you. Now everyone will see what we've all known. And I said that to Sebastian when his first special came out, because he was like this guy that's just frustrated. No one knows me. Nobody likes me. Yeah. It's like, boom. You just have to keep doing you, being you, and mm-hmm. they will know. If you build it, they will learn about it.
Yeah, right.
One more question, because mm-hmm. this is my favorite game that I only play with my Jewish guests. And then mm-hmm. it's called Jewish, Jewy. Mm-hmm. And this determines whether you are just Jewish or
yes.
really full-on Jewy. Are you ready?
Oh, boy. Yeah.
Don't be nervous. And it's based, I'll give you a hint. It's off of Eli, what Eli just did. Finish this, the third word in this song. Elu, Elu.
Oh, I know this.
I'll do it again. Elu, Elu.
Why is it based on Eli?
No, because Eli did a thing also with the Afikoman. It's because it's in the Seder. The song.
Right.
Is
that's
in the
I know the song. It's like, but I'm
the song is Dayenu.
Oh, so.
But it's not. Oh. The word is not Dayenu. It's Elu, Elu, Ho.
Hotzianu.
Yes.
Yes. Jewy! I am pretty Jewy. I'm serious.
I know you are.
Yeah.
I love you, Jessica. I will let
I
you
love
go
you
make
too.
Your phone call. Thank
Guy,
you. Come back
you
in a few weeks
best.
And talk to
I
us.
I would come back anytime, Elon. I love you.
I
you're
love
really
you,
brilliant. And this show is just, your mother is every single person I grew up. Like your whole, it's all what I grew up with in Jersey.
We had auditions at Central Casting for who could play my mother, and she nailed it.
Hysterical with the father, with the you screaming, and I mean, it's so familiar to me. I love you.
Thank you. I love you. Thank you. We'll see you next time.
Bye, Stay safe. Jeff.
Love. Bessie Kirson, everybody. What an appearance! What a comedian! What a woman! What an everything! We didn't even scratch the surface with Jessica. That's what I love about this show. You just get a little taste, a little teaser. A little riffing back and the process. We're learning about the process. Where is the brothers Koren? Because I couldn't think of a better way to end this besides Donald Trump, who, yes, Donnie Zoldan, the owner of Stand Up New York is watching, just said the best. Bobby Moore, great TV producer, produced Tom Green Show, all these great shows, is giving us hearts and thumbs up. Everybody loves Jessica. Where is the brothers Koren, and then we're going to bring on the president, and then we're going to call it a night. We're enjoying our Wine Wednesday, everybody. Have a l'chaim on me, everybody. Did I fire Willie is the question. No, but it's imminent. Where are the brothers? Did the brothers Koren for? Some people are just saying, hi, Elon. Love Jess. Yeah, I love Jess too. Did we forget? Did they forget that they have a musical appearance? Because I didn't announce them at the top of the show. Maybe they left us. Maybe we'll talk to the president first, and then we'll talk to the brothers Koren, formerly known as the Kin. All right. Oh, there they are. Sorry, there they are. I'm sorry. I'm just a little out of it today. I've been drinking. It's Wine Wednesday, everybody. It's Wine Wednesday. They're here. Okay. So we have Isaac and hi guys.
We made it. Sorry, we're technically inefficient. It's our
no.
Strength.
I'm an idiot in every way. When I look, you're getting hearts just because you're so good looking. Like you're the only guest I've ever had on so far that the second your face is popped on, hearts are flying. Like, oh my God, they're so handsome. And Jessica, if you're not on the call and you're still watching, this is what I meant. By the Aryan Nation's wet dreams right here. This is what they wanted. They wanted this. So you guys, I love your music. You were formerly known as the Kin, which means like brothers, because you're brothers.
Yeah, exactly.
And yeah. Why did you change your name to the Brothers Koren?
Well, what a great question. Well, the Kin, you know, is still our band. We just we hung it up for some years. It, you know, there's rumors we'll do some more Kin songs, but since that time, since we've seen you, I think musically robbed your house, if I recall.
I will tell that story, but go ahead. Why'd you change?
Well, we kept making music, but we helped a bunch of other people make music for the last 4 or 5 years, and then we came out with this acoustic duo record, and we've just been doing more and more things, just the two of us.
Yeah, I mean, we really feel like the drummer and Jonathan, who connected us together, knows Shake a Leg, our drummer. He just feels such a part of what the Kin became, even though he's a brother from another mother. So when we continued to sing songs together, my brother and I, we felt that we had to kind of go on as just Brothers Koren, because it left a space for the kin to exist again someday as the
That's
three
so of great. And you're producing other people's music too.
We are, yeah.
And particularly people that don't feel like they can sing or ever picked it up or like hung it up and went and got a real job. We help people from all around the world claim their songs and voices.
And where are you guys from again? I just forgot this.
Down under, which...
20 years ago, though.
Wait, where are you from? We lost you with the Wi-Fi.
From Australia, South Australia, down under.
Oh, from Australia.
That. Yeah.
Right.
Originally.
But
so I'm going to tell the quick story about Willie and you guys, and then would you play a song for us? Would
Absolutely.
That be so nice. Oh, awesome. Okay. So just quickly, Willie was at our house. It was Shabbat dinner, and I think it was his birthday, and we wanted to surprise him. And you guys, as you say, musically robbed our house. You burst through the front door playing and singing. Willie went, ah! He screamed and didn't know what was happening. It was a musical robbery. Then
it goes like this. It goes,
ladies and gentlemen, this is a musical robbery. Yes.
You
walked in screaming that. Well, this is a musical robbery. It was the best Shabbat dinner ever. Nothing like two goyim coming in and just serenading us. So can you serenade us now?
We'd love to. Well, you know, would you like something that's moving? Or, you know, to be honest, we heard you say they might be the two least Jewish men alive, but we did kind of have this biblical story that came to us called Abraham that we wrote a number of years ago, and we played it in every denomination, many synagogues.
Please do that. Please.
Yeah. It's a song.
Okay,
of
I'll step away.
It's a song.
No,
of peace.
No, thank you, guys.
Step away. Stay, please.
No, I watch from here. Okay. You don't want to see my distracting, ugly, big face. Ladies and gentlemen, enjoy the Brothers Koren.
This is a song of peace about two brothers that have been fighting for many thousands of years. It goes like this.
There's a tale told by sailors of two sons and their father as they sail to old Palestine. True were these brothers, they sailed to bury their father. They would fight for Jerusalem. You will be meek when I am able. It should be the salt upon the table. When all is said and done, could you somehow be sons of Abraham? I was told by a stranger, a young lad thrown to the desert, he united the people with his hands. To the crescent, he fed the land to the thirst. He was dried to the spring of Zemzem. You will be meek when I am able. You'll be the salt upon the table. When all is said and done, could you somehow be sons of Abraham? You will be meek when I am able. You'll be the salt upon the table. But when all is said and done, could you somehow be sons of Abraham? There's a tale told by soldiers of a young boy taken to slaughter. He was saved by his father's hand. Whoa, he was Christ and protected the prince who was he elected. He
starts to save the wolves with a lamb. You will be meek when I am able. You'll be the salt upon the table. When all is said and done, could you somehow be sons of Abraham? You will be meek when I'm able. You'll be the salt upon the table. When all is said and done, could you somehow be a sons of Abraham?
Wow, that was absolutely beautiful. I just love when guys just expose their soul and just play and harmonize, and you just bring so much joy to people, and you're so talented, and I can't thank you guys enough. Would you come back on and fix your Wi-Fi and do that again?
Absolutely.
All right, that was just amazing. The brothers Koren, everybody. We'll see you next time. Thank you guys. You're just beautiful. And now we're going to close it out with a brief briefing with the that was amazing. People are saying incredible, amazing, unbelievable. Yeah, if only the Wi-Fi was better, that would have even been more magical than it was. The President of the United States, it's always important to check in. I'm trying to connect. Invite yourself, Bob, because it's not working as far as me inviting you. That was what a great show this was today. That was next level. Let me hear the comments while we're waiting for Bob to invite himself on the live. What did everybody think of today's show? Just say your one word or two word answers about today's show, Wine Wednesday show, and then we're gonna have the president close us out. I understand there's an 8 second delay, so I'll wait. There are a lot of hearts. I wanna see comments. Getting better and better. That's kind of negative. It's like it wasn't good. It's getting better. It was okay. Now it's dynamite. That's when I too Jewish. Avi Lieberman, very good. Wow. Yes, wow. Love the part where I got to drink wine. That was Jessica, our audience. Jessica, are you enjoying the wine? I did refill her cup in the middle while the kin was playing. I walked over and refilled her cup. And now it's time for a brief briefing. You were eating and you were almost choked. At which joke? Which joke did you choke, almost choke on? I actually would like to hear that. No. There's someone saying I was eating and I almost choked. Who was that? Someone just commented that. At which joke did you almost choke? I love the silly humor. There's nothing silly here. This is serious comedy we're doing. There's nothing silly. Dad, where's the Yiddish word of the day while Bob is trying to invite himself live? Because his Wi-Fi was not working moments ago. Yeah, where is Bob? Yeah, where is Bob and where is Dad? Hi, Canada. Who else is in the house? We're dragging the show out now. I don't like when it drags out. And then I hate when my friends talk to each other as if I'm not doing an important, life-changing, earth-shattering show here.
You're making God's day.
Yeah, no late-night people doing this. It's all Elon all night. I love you, too. I love you, too. Wait, Bob just invited himself. Now it'll work. Okay, here we go. And then you're up next. Here we go. Mr. President, we're running very low on time. We had Eli, I want to thank. Amazing, stellar appearance. We had Jeff Carlin says it's not a show, and it didn't work. I think he's having Wi-Fi issues today.
Back to Yiddish
word. Invite yourself one more time. I should just do a 24-hour show. That's an excellent idea. Thank you, Suit Cafe. I will. And by the way, if you're interested in suits, go to Suit Cafe. That's not a commercial. That's a real thing. Thank you. Sid, come on back for the Yiddish word of the day while Bob tries to invite himself live again. Bob's Wi-Fi is not working today. Sid, tell us what the Yiddish word of the day is.
Borvis.
And what does it mean?
It means barefoot. So I try to tell my grandchildren not to walk around Borvis here And they do, and they got stung on the bottom of their foot by a bee because they walked around Borvis. Next time, wear your shoes or socks.
Excellent lesson. Show the word. Look at that. Borvis. Borvis? Thank you, Dad. Thank you for that Yiddish word of the day and that short and sweet message. We always love having you on. Prepare your word for tomorrow.
I'll go prepare for today because I don't see the president.
The president is every time I invite him, it's not working. Can we FaceTime with the president and bring him on that way? Because I'd rather say hi to him than not. Why don't you FaceTime him and we'll bring him on that way because he's not coming through here. Rachama is requesting to be on live. This is not the show. That's the buffer that you're allowed to be on. This is a professional show business show, Rachama. I'm sorry. This Herzog wine is just fantastic. We're still waiting for the president. Evan, are you able to get him on FaceTime?
I can put him there.
Bob, say hi one more time. Yeah, put him there. And let's not
cover
get...
the screen for a
second. I'll cover the screen so we don't put his number out there. And Bob, say hi one more time in the comments, and we're going to try you one more time this way. Thank you, Jessica Kirson. Thank you, Eli. Thank you, Dad. Thank you, Mom. Thank you all for watching. Rachama, it's not going to happen. This is a real show. It's one of the best shows. It's the second best show on phones. Oh, Mr. President!
Hey, it's great to be here. Thank you.
I almost like you like this and not split screen. It's almost like a CNN type of interview.
Well, this is not the Corrupt News Network. Let's not talk about the Corrupt News Network.
So you were having some Wi-Fi issues, Mr. President. Is everything all right? Are you in the bunker?
Unfortunately.
Are you sitting right now?
He had made one of his stupid dinners from Slovenia and it didn't agree with me as usual.
So when Melania makes you a dinner from Slovenia, it goes sort of right through you.
Well, it doesn't agree with me, just like her. We never get along.
A lot of people don't agree with you, Mr. President. That is a running theme here in your presidency. Why don't you tell us what's going on today? He's making an orange poop. The poop is orange. I like that. Alicia, that was funny. Well, I'm sorry. Well, I wasn't listening. I was reading a funny comic. Go ahead.
Well, I just said the testing is coming down. The numbers are coming down around the country. And I think everybody knows that this whole thing is a total scandemic. That's what I call it, a scandemic.
Right. Even though
Fauci is a total idiot. I call him Tony Baloney.
I noticed he hasn't been in your briefings lately. You got rid of him?
Well, yeah, because I can't trust him. He's an idiot. He doesn't know what he's talking about.
So tell us what else you wanted to talk about today, Mr. President, because I forgot.
Well, as you know, I'm very upset about the whole thing with the Aunt Jemima.
Right, that was it. What happened with that?
Well, they want to take down... First of all, they said that the picture of Aunt Jemima was racist.
Right.
And I don't... First of all, look at the picture closely. For years, I thought it was Dionne Warwick. I had no idea.
Okay.
And then they said it's racist, and I don't think it's racist. I think everybody loves waffles. Everybody loves pancakes. It's the greatest American breakfast in the history of breakfasts. Everybody knows that. And everybody, I think, in the world wants to wake up every morning with Aunt Jemima. I mean, not in your bed, obviously. That would be a sin. But on your breakfast table, you'd love it.
I understand. And what else did you want to talk about today? Because I forgot to write down what you texted me. What's that?
I called Pepsi and I said to Pepsi, I said, I'm not going to let you do it.
Uh-huh.
I'm not going to let you change the picture or the icon.
Right.
So I said, I'm going to sign an executive order that you could change the name. So instead of Aunt Jemima, it's going to be now called Aunt Jemima.
You mean ain't your mama?
Aunt your mama.
Aunt your mama?
That's right. Aunt your mama. And let me say this. This whole thing has gotten out of control because now anytime you do anything and there's something white involved in it, you're racist. You know that, right?
Right, right. I heard that, right.
Like, last night, Melania was out, and I'm like, let me rent a porno. haven't done it in a long time. Okay.
Right. You've done porn actors. You don't need to rent the movie. You have the actors come over to you.
I think you know that.
Right.
Absolutely. So the first movie that comes up is called White College Sluts.
Uh huh.
And you know what? I said to myself, Elon. I said, if I rent it, the word's going to get out to the big boobs, and they're going to say I'm racist.
Well, because
you know what I had to do?
What?
I had to rent Black Wives Matter.
Was that on there? I've never seen that on the internet. Is that on there, Mr. President?
It's a great movie, actually.
All right. Well, thank you, Mr. President. Thank you so much for being here, and enjoy that. Send me the link to that, would you? Send me the link to that movie. Thank you, Mr. President. Thank you all for watching. And we'll see you tomorrow. It's Great Comedy Writing Legend Day with Alan Zweibel, Robert Smigel, and Triumph, the insult comic dog. We'll see you tomorrow, everybody. Thank you so much for watching. I never felt so strong.